Let's add a teapot mesh. Please activate an add-on called Extra Objects and Tissue to follow along. Tissue add-on works like this. We need to have a source mesh and a target mesh. Select the source mesh first, and the target mesh next. Type N to bring up the property window, and go to Edit. Under Tissue Tools, click Tessellate, and click the OK button at the bottom. The add-on will allow us to replace the target mesh's faces with our source mesh. Again, we need to activate an add-on called Tissue in order to use this feature. Control 3 to subdivide. Let's type G and X to move this object aside and make more examples. Planes work really well with the Tissue add-on. Tab, to go to edit mode, A, to select all, right click and S, to subdivide, and remove two faces like this. This time, let's use a UV sphere as our target mesh. I'll add the solidify modifier. That mesh would have been very difficult to model. Let's continue with more examples. I'll create a chain like source mesh. Control R to place a loop cut. The end result can be fully customized when we apply interesting source mesh shapes. Let's try a honeycomb mesh. That's a highly complex mesh, and how fast did we model that one by using the Tissue add-on? Let's set up the render scene and apply the materials. Please watch a tutorial listed in the description to match my final render settings, as I'm using a cloned look dev HDRI setting. I'll use the sky texture. Let's turn off. Use nodes, under compositing. I'll also use 32 samples to render. This is the end of the tutorial. Please like and subscribe if you have enjoyed watching this tutorial. Thank you for watching.